We were touring for a year after the last album came out, but we didn't start touring straight away, so that took, you know, just over a year to finish promoting that album. And then we were so tired, we decided to take some time off and just to be able to step away from the industry and not have to think about it for a while. So we did that and did some writing. That took up another year, just relaxing and writing. And then the start of 87, we went into the studio for the first time with a producer. And that went on for 10 months, which is a long time, until myself and Roland realised that it really wasn't going that well and it wasn't what we wanted to do. It wasn't new enough. It wasn't breaking any new grounds. It was becoming quite similar to the album before. So we decided that we wanted to do it ourselves. So we scrapped that and again took a couple of months off to think about exactly what we wanted to do. It wasn't until January 88 we started recording. So it's only really taken us a year and a half, but because of the false start and because of all the work we did after the last album and the fact we needed a rest, it's been 4.5 years.
Together as musical partners, I asked Curt how his relationship with Roland Orzabal had changed.
I suppose, if anything, we're not as close friends as we used to be, although having said that, we've become a lot closer in the last year doing this record together. There was a while when we just became kind of business partners, because if we were in the studio all day, the last thing we wanted to do is see each other at night. And you have a business partnership anyway. That makes a lot of money, so you have to go to business meetings, you know, and we're both chairman of a company and all that kind of stuff, and that tends to be a bit weird to start with. But I think over the last couple of years we've learned to deal with that and relax in the situation, so again we've become quite close friends again. So in that sense I don't think it's changed really that much since we were 13. I mean, it just feels as natural as it did back then.
You've often come over as the more approachable one of the two, whereas Roland appears to be the terribly intense or angst-ridden one. Yeah. Is that fair or unfair? Is that the press?
I don't think it's fair, particularly. I mean, I am a bit more open than Roland, but I think the fact that people have that image of him makes it a lot worse, you know? I mean, when people meet him and they don't know him, it's fine. But if people meet him and think, oh my God, I'm going to meet someone who's difficult, then he's going to play on it, probably. I mean, you know, it's his humour, I think, is the worst thing, because he's very dry, his humour, you know. So, no, it's not completely true, but I am the more approachable of the two, but I don't think it's a drastic difference.